your food today. I am your master. Your task is to guard the artifact before you. Let no one touch it.
In Europe, during the time of the Inquisition, paranoia and corruption ran deep. With the fear of devilry running rampant, the ancients' corruption extended far beyond mortal knowledge, corrupting all that could be corrupted. My researches uncovered an interesting incident. A Franciscan monk named Paul Luther was traveling through the region of Amiens during the witch hunts of the Inquisition. Now, under martial law, the Inquisition prevented anyone from leaving the town and its nearby cathedral, for everyone was suspect.
Welcome to Oubliette Cathedral,
Brother Luther. I'm glad that our sacred order can bestow hospitality on our Franciscan brethren.
I shall not impose, Excellency. I merely request lodging and a viewing of the sacred relic, the Hand of Jude.
Many have traveled far and even risked their lives for a glimpse of the hallowed relic's true splendor. Of course, it would be wise to keep quiet during your stay. The Inquisition is here for a reason, brother. We seek to purge the deviancy from this town.
I am sure that will not be a problem. Amiens appears to be a peaceful hamlet.
It appears to be. But deviancy is secreted in the most deceptive places, which I believe is the case with Amiens.
Then I wish you luck in your search.
The Inquisition does not need luck, Brother Luther. Faith and purity are our guides.
For the love of God! God! Help! Come quickly!
A murder! A murder most foul! What heresy is this?
I found him lying here, dead. I called the guards.
Ah. Is this our first suspect? Make sure no one touches the body. It must be examined for signs of devilry. As for this man, make sure he doesn't leave the cathedral. We will question him later.
But...
Hold your tongue, Franciscan, or it might bring my wrath upon thee. Who is to say that you did not commit this murder? If you trust in the Almighty, and you are indeed innocent, then you will have nothing to fear.
Are you here to pass sentence on me?
No. I'm here to free you. You are in incredible danger. This cathedral used to be a place of peace. Now many strange things happen here. I don't want you to end up like the others.
What do you mean?
The body you found was Brother Andrew, and he was killed to protect a secret. We can't talk about it here. Find me in the bell tower later, and I shall aid thee further.
Why are you releasing me?
I don't want to see another innocent die like your Franciscan brethren. I have seen Brother Andrew make numerous entries into his journal. This may contain the answers to the cathedral's dark secrets.
What can I do?
If I were you, I'd run.
They will surely hunt me if I run. This has to stop.
Then be it on your own head, Luther. Find Brother Andrew's journals if you can. He spent time in the old tower investigating. I believe I can find the key to the old tower in one of my stores. Later, come find me in the bell tower, and I will give it to you. Be swift. We can't evade them forever. Ah, Brother Luther, not a moment too soon. As you have noticed, dread things inhabit this place. Shambling corpses, and worse.
There is darkness at work here, in the midst of the Inquisition.
I suspect it is worse than that, but I have no proof. Brother Andrew knew this also, and paid the price for it.
Why are you telling me this?
Perhaps you can finish off what Andrew started. Take this key. It unlocks the old tower. It has been sealed off since the Inquisition arrived.
I intend to uncover the truth behind this.
If you manage to uncover the source of darkness, return here, and I will do everything I can to help. Till then, brother, may your faith protect you.
Glickmok. Thank you. Thank you. can't be happening!
Brother Andrew suspected Augustine all along. I managed to find remnants of his journal, and it all points to Augustine's involvement with a paganistic cult operating inside the cathedral.
Aye, the cathedral's dark secret has been uncovered. I too suspected this, but was too afraid to act. Augustine himself is a heretic.
He has covered his tracks well, claiming that the sacred relic, the Hand of Jude, was stored here. He had those who came to see it murdered. The Hand of Jude never existed.
And with that realization, the trap closes, brother. My days here are numbered. I awoke to find this cruel dagger placed upon my pillow this morn. It can only mean one thing. I know too much, and they are moving to silence me. I can only hope that what little faith I have left is enough to save my soul. Please, take this thing away from me. Its very sight troubles me to no end. May your faith protect thee, Brother Luther, for that's all you have. Thank you.
this isn't really happening!
Clever man, Brother Luther. Wanting answers to clarify your new position as fugitive, you seek them out, and this is what you find. Tell me, what does a man such as yourself think of when he finds a viper's nest of heresy, when he finds the very source of corruption?
I think of irony. Irony of what you, masquerading as a member of the Inquisition, stand for. And that you stand for evil.
Evil is merely a perspective which no longer concerns me, Luther. You will be executed in the most painful manner imaginable. After we have broken your frail body and mine, in the name of our true lord, Zelotov. Come, my children, feast on this morsel, and let us return to our preparations.
Thank you.
Your task, my liege and greater guardian, is to guard this place. Do not worry about this worm. His kind yelps in terror at the sight of your mightiness. We will dispose of him ourselves.
The Black Guardian grows restless, my liege. Its hunger increases, and the binding continues to weaken. We feed it flesh, but I fear it will not guard the relic too much longer.
There is no choice in the matter. It must remain and guard the artifact until the time of planetary alignment. After that, the Guardian may return to its lair. Our master does not like failure. It is imperative to keep the binding intact.
Then we have to find more flesh and bone.
The war to end all wars redefined how mankind looked at war and the value of human life. Over 19,000 men lost their lives every day in the trenches of the Somme. Some say uselessly, some invoke a higher cause. I read accounts of the slaughter from many journalists who spent time in the trenches, but I found the account of a certain Peter Jacob to be the most horrible of all. His implication about the ancients' involvement with the war was hideous and so obvious. With the horror of the Battle of the Somme scant miles away and the distant echoes of pounding artillery, a young journalist named Peter Jacob researched his latest story from the front lines. His grim task brought him to Oubliée Cathedral, now transformed into a field hospital.
I find no solace in the purpose behind all the senseless violence that surrounds me.
Young men die at a rate unheard of in centuries of warfare. Shelling, machine guns, and mustard gas. Rip, pierce, and burn to flesh. Men soak gauze in their own urine to stop the insidious gas. The hospitals here cannot cope with the torrent of wounded.
Thank you.
This isn't really happening.
here?
Thank you.
And that was how I came by it. I know it sounds crazy, but there you have it. The only proof I have is that statue.
It's a strange one. I've seen one like it before.
You have?
Yes. Very rare, though. Very obscure.
I've had experts take a look at it, and none of them know what it is. And you do.
I'm somewhat of an expert on these things myself. An interest I developed a long time ago while I was a young man.
Then you should keep it. Lord knows I have no interest in it. I am sure it's the cause of my sleeplessness. I keep thinking about it. As if it's calling out to me.
Then a drink, perhaps. For the gift. For an unusual objet d'art.